curiosity. Don't read anything into it. How are you feeling?
Crapping myself, since you ask.
You'll be fine.
I feel like a different person, like the person I'm supposed to be, if that makes any sense.
Took your time getting there.
Not there yet, am I?
Mr. Walsh!
Enjoyed the show.
You live in London, Mr. Walsh?
If I'm lucky enough to be selected, I'll move here to live, of course.
As the son of a Viscount and all the privilege of that, how can you expect to win the votes of the working people in our constituency?
I am here in spite of my background, not because of it. Since time immemorial, my family has been conservative. I make no secret of it. But I hope the fact I broke with that, turning my back on my family to stand for Labour, will be a symbol to the voters of the depth of my commitment.
In your view, where was it we went wrong at the election?
What is the country to show from the last Labour government? An economy riven by strikes, rising unemployment, in hoc for billions. I mean, add to that, we... Add to that our Faustian pact with the unions, you have your answer. We've devised a system where at party conference, one man, one single individual can raise his hand and account for hundreds of thousands of votes, while our own rank and file members, like those of you here today, ordinary, decent, working people, are excluded from having a voice in your own party. As the Tories roll back the state with their draconian cuts, every man, woman and child in this country will pay the price for our failure to put our house in order. We've betrayed the very people who we're supposed to protect. In doing so, we've betrayed the moral values which define us. Until we're able to admit that failure, we'll remain not just unelected, but unelectable for generations to come.
Thanks for doing that.
Well, I could barely keep up with her.
She turned up at my flat this morning. She does that. She just won't stay on her medication. Last week, the police rang in the middle of the night. She was in the street outside her flat shouting obscenities at a neighbour. She thought he'd put a camera in the party wall to spy on her.
Well, can her doctor not do something?
Short of sectioning her again. And I can't let that happen.
Such a load to carry on your own. He pulled it off then?
His finest hour, arguably. Jay and I went for moral support. Like I said to him, don't go reading anything into it.
He bought that, did he?
He's not the issue.
This is it! I haven't seen the dance!
damn thing. I'm over the limit, but Jacqueline does these. The cake shop on Clarence Road. Can't Jack go himself? He's over the limit too. Please. Oh. Thank you.
You fancy a spin?
Due to course.
But don't you move from that spot.
You have kids. You want to do your best for them. You want them to have everything you didn't. I couldn't always dither with that for our Lily. Not for the want of trying. No, it's true. When she came down to London to do her art thing, I didn't get it. But then she's always followed her own star. And that's led her to him. I knew when she first brought him home that he'd do right by her. He's pulled himself up by his bootstraps, made a future for himself. Mind you, if you ever let her down, it's not just Ali who can sting like a bloody bee.
To Lily
and Alan, we wish you health and wealth. Above all, happiness. To Lily and Alan.
Where the hell is Victor in that cake?
Victor up on a stop and search. They found cocaine in your car. They're charging him with possession. You have to go there, Jack. Put it right.
If I do, I'm screwed. I'll finish before I've even started.
What about Victor? He'll be struck off.
You could say they planted it. Be their word against his, won't it? You have to ask him, Charlie. Tell him what's at stake. He'd do it for you.
What's it you said in your interview? About being defined by moral values. Bloody prove it, Jack.
Proved it.
You hesitated, Jack. You hesitated.
Thank you very much, Officer.
Right, you have access to a telephone. I suggest you make a call and resign your candidacy before the press get hold of it. At least retain some modicum of dignity. There's nothing you have to say, Jack, that I want to hear.
Dad, I've heard it all before. I'm not fool enough to fall for it again.
I thought it best if I leave her there. I've made the bed up in Victor's old room, if you fancy.
Thanks, sweet.
Mm.
my cub runneth over.